Good evening, everybody. This is the last talk of the CentOS Dojo. I am Chandan Kumar. I will be speaking on OpenStack for CentOS. How many of you know about OpenStack? You guys does not know about OpenStack. No problem. So I am going to explain it. So OpenStack is a collection of open source projects through which you can build your public and private cloud. So we also call it as a cloud operating system through which you can make your own cloud at home. It's kind of similar to AWS, but that is the closed source one, this is the open source one. So since OpenStack has a collection of projects, as I would say, so cloud is nothing. It's just another computer and their pieces are kept at different places. So in cloud, we need compute, storage, networks, and other services. So in OpenStack, we have Nova to provide compute services, Cinder to provide log storage services. We have Glance to provide image, through which you can boot an instance. We have Neutron to provide networking services. We have Swift to provide object storage services. And apart from that, all services interact through another services that is known as eStore, identity service. So if two services want to interact with each other, they need the first services need to notify the keystone, and the keystone generates a token through which they can make connection with the other services. So your things will be separated everywhere. All in the cloud, all things are connected through wires, and through this cloud, it can visualize and use all the resources for a single dashboard. So, for deploying OpenStack, you can use various methods. You can pick one component at a time and install from source as well as from the package created by different distributions like CentOS, Ubuntu, SUSE. You can also use community supported tools like DevStack, PackStack, and Tripler. So, DevStack basically installs all the things from the source, PackStack installs all the things from Puppet module, and behind the scenes it consumes the CentOS package created by CentOS OpenStack package created by RDO. So RDO is just an acronym, it has no full form. So RDO produces lots of OpenStack packages which are more than 500 or 600 in numbers, more than that. You can include all the dependencies, everything. And RDO stands for RPM-based distribution of OpenStack, as well as somebody calls it a group of people who rapidly deploy OpenStack, or if your name starts with R, it's your own OpenStack, like Richard OpenStack Distribution. Okay. So deploying OpenStack, since OpenStack is massively very large, it has more than 400 to 500 projects. If you check the GitHub repository, it has more than 1800 repositories. So if you try to install it from source, it will end up like a hell. So there was a talk in the morning in the event hall 101 where Matt tries to install all the stuff from the source, and he was describing the challenge there. So since deploying OpenStack from source is hard, so why not let's package it and let the distributions handle the pain and make you a pizza and serve it to you so that you can just directly eat it. And why not you do not package it, let the community handle it, those who are expert in that. So we are talking about the package. Basically refers to the RPM packages on CentOS land or Fedora RHEL distributions. So package name, so like if you do package something like this, so this is basically the package. It's a Python package. So it says the name, project name, that's the version, and there is something known as release. And this is the tag on which, like, it's a EL7, which is on CentOS 7, you can use it on RHEL also. So basically we call it NVR, name version release.rpm, since it's install.rpm analysis. And a RPM scales from SRPM. SRPM is source plus spec file. When we save our source, it's basically the source code of a package or a project. And within this RPM and the RPL, there are lots of files. And RPM is just a packaging format. So like just like zip or tar, it's the another packaging format. So since I was saying about this, SRPM consists from source code plus a spec file. So within the spec file, it's just a another configuration file format which is understood by the RPM utility tool and which has all the metadata information about a package, how to build, install, remove a package, some system unit files. If you have some pre and post configurations method, there you can plug it. And if you want to include some patches, there you can place it. So as I told earlier, you can find out the NVR of any project hyphen using RPM-Q. Moving ahead, what are the tools we require for creating a package on CentOS? So basically you need a CentOS packager. So they have bundled all the stuff within CentOS packager. But if you do not want to use CentOS packager, you can directly install two things, RPM build and Red Hat RPM config. So Red Hat RPM config basically contains the macros related to that. I'm coming to the macros also. And after that, we need to add the user to the mock group. You can run these commands to add this. And after that, you have to create the RPM packaging workspace. So let me bring the terminal line. So to create the workspace, you need to run the command rpm dev setup tree. So what it will do, it will create a rpm build folder like this. If you do tree, so each of these five directories have a lot of stuff. I have my previous files, so ignore that. So in build, when we do the RPM packaging process, all the build root and all the things are created under build and build root. So the sources we keep, that the source code target goes on the sources. We keep the spec file in the specs, and then we keep the SRPM under the SRPM folders. Once we build the package, all the RPMs generally get stuff under RPMs. Okay. So here I'm going to package a single simple Python application, and it has nothing. So last night I found a simple GitHub sample project. So if you're working on a Python project, PYPA has created a sample Python project. So I generally try to package this one. So one thing, so since you are going to package a Python project, what are the things you need to take care of? First thing is you need to take care about open the CentOS.py file. It has lots of the information which you are going to use it. So check for the third party models, like, so like setup tools is a Python third party model. Another like codex comes by default, OS comes by default. And these are the setup method metadata, and these are, I am going to use it basically. Apart from that, we need to check for the few things like install requires. So some of the projects does not have requirement or txt, so you can check for this also, but it is optional, not needed. And another thing you need to look for is package data, it's okay. So these are the data files. We need also need to take care of that. And another is the entry points. So basically, so in Python, these entry points create an executable which are directly dumped into the /user bin. So like this sample executable will be dumped into /user bin. So we need to take care of that.
Okay, I have explained these things. So since I have already cloned this project, so first thing, this is the code. First, I have to create a tarball. So in Python, you can create tarball like something like this, Python setter py sdist. And in the build section, if you check, sorry, build section, lsdist, here is the tarball. I'm going to just copy this tarball to the sources folder, a copy a build. Let me come to the source. Okay, I'm here. You can create a new spec for any project like RPM dev new spec. There is a command. Like you can create something food.spec. It will generate something like this. Okay, this is the layer. So these are the labels basically.
I need to squeeze this a little bit.
Okay, now it's visible. Yeah. So we call these labels. So you can fill this information from the setter.py file. Like, what is the name of the package? So I'm going to create. So like since I have given food, that's why food is taken, the working should be taken. Release is basically related to the spec file. So any times you modify the spec file, you need to change the release. This is basically auto taken by the distributions. You have to summary what the project does. License, you need to give that. So since, so CentOS is a rebuild of Rail, and in Rail, all the packages mostly inherit from the Fedora land. And Fedora is very strict about licenses, project licenses. So Fedora has a long list of licenses into source. If you are going to package any project next year, it completes with the licenses list. So sometimes it happens that a single project uses multiple licenses. So you need to specify that also whether they are compatible or not. Then it's the project URL. Source 0 is basically the from where the source tarball will be used. So currently all the Python projects source tarballs are kept on PyPA. So you can download it there. This is the build requires. So when you run the Python, your pip install -e dot, but first is does, what is does is it invokes Python setter.py build. So when building the project, it just it will just try to create the egg info file and everything. So during build request, we generally require Python devil and setup tools because we are invoking the setup.py file, which is dependent on the setup tools. And if it's an OpenStack project, some other dependencies are required, like Python PBR or if something others is given. And it requires, these are the runtime dependencies when you execute an executable or when you actually run your application. And that's the description, is the long description. You can get it from the readme file. And from the preparation section, these are actually another kind of label from which actually another steps happens. So here, setup minus Q, here it will extract the tarball, enter into that. And at this place, if you provide some patches, you can link it here by linking patch 0123. And you can pass minus flag P1. That it that time it will use the git, will create a user RPM and apply the patches, and that it will proceed. So in the build step, you can do build stuff. So it is from the make file, and in the install, you can do the Python setter.py install, and here you can basically going to place the files. So let me open the sample project. So see here. So last night I have done that. So this is the name. So by packaging, you have to take care of the RPM packaging naming convention also. If it's a Python project, you have to specify like Python something. Yeah, if it's a C, they have their own naming conventions. If it's a Golang or Ruby, they have their own naming conventions in Fedora. So that an end user can easily identify whether it's a Fedora, sorry, it's a Ruby or Python package or Rustline package. So here, I have given the license. URL source, this is the source which I have grabbed from the PyPI. I need to identify the architecture. So like if it's a Golang package, they have their different architecture, the Python. So it's basically dependent on Python, since Python, if Python is installed on that, it will run. So I have to give no architecture, build requires, I have given Python table, Python script tools. Let's go on down. So currently we use auto setup, it's similar to setup. Do the same thing. Here I have used Py to build. These are basically the macros and nothing else. So you can evaluate the macros, like what it does from here, like this. RPM-eval. So this is the method which creates this macro. You can create your own. It's very simple. I've written blog about it. So this will basically invoke Python setter.py build, and this will invoke Python setter.py install. If you want to run unit test, you can introduce another section label here, percentage check. So there you can call Python setter.py install. And just below, you have to provide all the files which you want to place. So under doc, you have to pass the readme. So it will resolve to something else. So like, it will paste the docs. It dumps all the things to users here. The forward syntax. And this is the Python site lib. It will dump the package in slash user lib python 2.7 site packages. So each of the directories have their own macros which is written in the Fedora documentation. And this bind directory is used for placing the executable into the slash user bin. You have some data if you want to place a particular directory. So slash user, we place that in slash user directory. And license, you have to keep at proper places. So the license macro will be used. And below that, you have to write your changelog. A changelog has a prescribed format like this. So first, date, then date, your name, signature, your version, then release, and what are the things you have done. You can also run RPM lint to check the sanity of that, like kind of similar to pipit. So it will check the syntax of your spec file. You can run the RPM lint on SRPM and RPM also. Now, first thing I'm going to create is create a spec SRPM. So if you run RPM build minus BA, path to spec file, it will create a SRPM. Come on, yeah. So this is the SRPM it has created. If you want to see what is there without extracting it, there is a command known as RPM ls. It's very useful. So it can tell you all the files from a RPM as well as SRPM. So if you are doubtful where is my files gone, you can run on that. Clear? So since I was saying earlier that SRPM, src.rpm contains two things, spec file, source code, tarball. Okay? And here is the location of the SRPM. It will directly dump into the SRPM. Now I'm going to build it. This is the command, it's simple, RPM build minus PA. And I'm going to give the path of spec file. Sorry. So what it will do, it will go to the spec file, run all the steps, and try to create a RPM package out of it. So where is the RPM? So here is the RPM package.
So if you check Evo, what are the things has happened, you can check here.
So it has created a build environment here. Okay. Then it's at prep section, it goes into this. And at build section, it has executed something like this macro python setter.py build.
Okay.
Then it goes to the install level. It has done called this macro python setter.py install.
And after that,
it creates the respective directories and copies the files from here to there.
And then compresses all the stuffs and creates an RPM for you. Clear? It's quite simple.
So this way you can build RPM any package on Fedora, CentOS, or RHEL. So to make it easier, to make the life of a package easier, they have written lots of tools. Like there is another known as CBS, CentOS packages, which provides an utility CBS. It works with the cbs.centos.org, which is basically developed from a software known as Koji. And there is another system known as Koji.fedora.org, that is the Fedora packaging build system. And on RHEL, there is a brew babe.devil.redder.com. So they have your different tools to interact with them. There is RDO PKG, Fate PKG to interact with the Koji, and CBS is to interact with the cbs.centos.org. So if you want to build a new package, if you want to add a new package to CentOS, first you have to find that where that package is going to fit. CentOS has lots of SIZs to work on different areas, focus areas. Like if you want to work on cloud, so there is a cloud SIZ. If you want to work on virtualization, there is a virtualization. If you are too much interested in containers, there is another PaaS SIZ also, and Atomic SIZ. So PaaS SIZ basically looks for the OpenShift, and there is Atomic Container SIZ basically look for the Atomic development. So first find where that package is needed, join the SSIZ. They have their own weekly meetings and everything. You can ask for them. They can add user member. After that, they can add your credentials on accounts.centos.org, and they will add you to the package group, and after that you can build it. I'm not part of any SIZ, so I'm not able to do it. It's pretty simple.
Next, coming to that, okay.
So next thing, I'm going to talk about packaging and OpenStack services, okay? So recently, in Quinn's release, in OpenStack, more than two new projects were added. One is Cyborg, which is related to NFV. So NFV is basically Network Functional Virtualization, which is used in telcos, telecommunications area. Like, if you use mobile phone where you see 4G, 5Gs, like most of them, they're running on OpenStack, like most of them. So if a new service pops up, how we add it in RDO. So that I'm going to say. So for that, RDO provides some tools. First tool is known as Delurian. Its spelling is DLRN. You can just do pip install Delurian. And before that, you have to install some packages. Which is written here in the blog. And after that, you can do pip install or you can do the Delurian git clone. If you write Delurian GitHub, here you can clone it. So I have already cloned it. And after that, you have to create a virtual environment. So I have already created a virtual env, if you can see that. .vnv, I can activate the. So
.bnb in activate.
Okay, and so and here Delorean is available. So Delorean is the continuous packaging and integration framework which is used by RDO to build all the packages from all the commits getting merged at all the times. So like suppose your project is added to the DeLorean, if any commits are getting merged, DeLorean will listen it, and DeLorean works on a package known as RDO info, which is all the metadata information related to all the packages, who are their maintainers, what are the versions linked with a particular release, what are the packages are getting promoted, and from which group they come generally. So in RDO we have defined groups like it's whether it's a library or a core project or a dependencies or on dependency level whether it's a Fedora or CentOS dependencies like that. And all the things get promoted from Git review. Even a single CVS build is triggered through a Git review. We also update all the dependencies for a project if a new version comes up using bots. And then we give +2 and workflow, then the code gets merged. There is a tool known as Graffiti, which interacts with the CVS to do a final tag build. And all the things are done automatically. So here, suppose you want to add a new package in RDO, how can you do that? So first thing I have to do, I have to add an entry in the RDO info. So first thing what I can do, so I can just do git clone. So here is the URL. So if you search for GitHub RDO info, you can get the URL, you have to clone it. So I have already cloned it. I have to create a branch first. So I can generally, for convention, add cyborg. I have given that. So all the information are available in RDO.aml, all the project's informations. And if you, there is another file known as dependencies.yaml which has Fedora CentOS dependencies. So I have open RDO.yaml, I will go and just copy one of the entry of anything. Or I can directly add my own. Like this. I will project. So I go. OpenStack cyborg. I do not know about the conf. So you can, there is a flag known as conf. So I need to check the, what is the conf or VM factory core. I think I can search for that. Yeah. That's for the core project. So come down RPM factory core. So if we use the conf, we do not need to give these two informations like where is the source code repository and where is the discrete server, because in the course they are defined like if this is, if project is this type, their discrete URL is this, and if and the source code is pointing to this. If you specifically want to overwrite that part, you have to manually give that. And one last thing, I have to add tags. So since this package is not available here, so I can add just under review tag. And nothing else. And another thing I have to add is maintainers. So for say currently I can add my name. So once it is done, I have to verify it. Okay. Awesome. Come on. Okay. Any more dependencies? Yeah, it's correct. So I will make a commit out of it. Git commit, add cyborg
OpenStack package. And apart from that, I have to create a Foxilla to do it. So buzzword.com, I have to go there. I have to look for the new. And here I have to select a community. And here I have to search for the audio. Okay, come on. And here I have to look for the package review. Component. Yes, come on. That's the build. I will specify package cyborg. Package OpenStack cyborg. I can give this. Here. I can provide some information so the reviewer can run license check on that. I'm just going to give the GitHub URL. And we create this box for just for tracking. And nothing else. So you must select a component and submit it. Awesome. So I can just add the bug here so that, and I can just send Git review, so it will create a review, so someone will see it. If it looks okay, it will give +2 than their previous auto-generated review will fire, and which will goes against the config project. That will, once we will merge that, it will create the discrete server and the job configurations for that. But if you want, you don't want to send a review, but you want to add a package locally and want to generate the RPM using Deloria, how can you do that? That's an interesting piece. So what I am going to do, so when you install Delorean, it creates a file folder that is known as .rdo.pkg. Within that .rdo.pkg, you can find the same RDO info repo. See, same thing. So what I am going to do here, I am going to just edit this rdo.yaml file. Just go downstairs and, but let me just do a diff here, a little better. So what I have done, I have added project, I have added name, I have pointed the upstream URL, okay, because if you are going to use the config, then it will use the something different. But here I have to override, and I have put my spec file on Git server. You can use the local Git URL also, pointing to a particular specific directory. And you have to add the maintainer. Yep. And after that, what do you have to do? You have to go to, where is your DeLorean? Packaging. After that, you want to package a new project service or a new module or new dependency which is coming from OpenStack or a new Puppet modules. So there are some sample spec example spec files. You can just copy it and override it, and your things will be done. You do not need to do anything. So we have added this sample spec file. You can just clone it based on your example. So suppose you are packaging an UI, so you can use this one. And if you are packaging a Tempest plugin, you can use this one. If you are packaging OpenStack service, since Cyborg is an OpenStack service, you can choose this one. And if you are using a Puppet, you can use this one. If you have library, you can use this one. And if it is a client, you can use this one. So these are the template. So since it's my A, OpenStack service, I can open this, I can just change view values and
keeping most of the things, I can update these things. So you have to replace examples with that. And when you start trying to build the RPM package, you can get the failures. And that's where you can start fixing the package. Once you fix the error, it will work promptly. So this way you can create. So one thing before creating, first thing you have to look here is, what are the services or executables present? So if you open setup.cfg file, so look for these things. The package is cyborg. So it sometimes it happens that a project has multiple packages. So you have to create multiple sub-packages also. Another thing, this policy is automatically generated, so you do not need to take care of that. You need to basically worry about this part. So first thing, you need to check the depth stack. In out of these, how many services they are creating? Might be DB sync, will be not a service. It might be a single executable will be called one time. But other three might be a service. So if it is a service, you have to create the unit files. So if you want to create the unit files, you do not need to worry about that also. So this is the sample examples. In the change few parameters and you are done, like for example this one. You have to write your own disk.conf, there is also example, and you can point where you want to dump your logs. And this should be same. And this disk.conf, I think. So they have not added it. So you can check all the spec files from here and you can pick up any of them. So like I can take the plans one, and here you can find something like disk.conf. So basically these are used for the configurations where they can generate and dump it. Now let's see how have I packaged this. So I was packaging for cyborg diskit. So I have created a repository known as cyborg diskit, and I have copied a bunch of files. Like I have considered four services, like cyborgs.log rated for the logging part, and I assume there are four services. I have not checked the depth stack repo, so I have created four systemd unit files. So if you check that, so later on you can fix the systemd unit files when you start trying to use it. If you find any problems, you can change the permissions of the flags. Slash like api.service, like it's similar. Like I need to change the user here. Copy pasted from. Yeah. So you need to change the few values, and later on you can manipulate once you start deploying it. And this is the complete spec which I have created. It's a long big spec. And so I have multiple sources, so I have used source 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here are the build requests. And one thing I want to show you, so like since it's a service, we are going to package the service, so we might need to run some script before and after that. So what there is something known as pre and post. Sorry, not this one. Yeah. So post means after deployment, and pre means before deployment, and there is something known. So if you restart things, these are the services will again call. So if you check the spec file of MySQL or Postgres, you can find lots of similar things. So if you are planning to package the new things, or if you are not understanding it, just look for the spec file. You can, so currently RDU also provides something like code search. RDUproject.org, I think. This one is the site. And here you can search, like we try to, like I have written pre. So it will try to search. Let's see how fast it is. It will take some time. started searching right now. Come on. Yeah, so here you can look for lots of examples like why the pacemaker is coming. So you can look for the proper thing, like you can find the examples here.
Okay, come on. Are you common? No.
So like here, like you can find much more examples like this, you can copy paste it, manipulate it. So these are the good like things to learn the things as you go ahead. Let's come to the building part, that is the most important thing. So if you want to build any new package, you can just do DeLorean -- package name and the name of the package which you have defined. It will download the package and it will create a data folder here, like something like this.
RDO packaging. Here is the DeLorean.
So it will create a data folder and within that it will clean the project from upstream code repository, and with Dextro here it places the spec file, all the spec file here for that project. So like, and I want to build it locally, so I can do that. And it has one config file also, project.ini, where you can change the values, like where to keep clone your stuff, what are the scripts, where from where you have to pull the packages with Dextro, which discrete branch you have to use, what is the source and the target, you can change it to Fedora also, what is the repo name you have to use, and everything, you can customize it. It also provides drivers so that if your Git repository somewhere is, and if some projects wants to consume this, they can use it. Like this one, it's a very nice feature implemented by Jetna. And so I'm going to run it, --config file. project.ini-package name, and I can give OpenStack cyborg, and I want to use the local audio info file which I have changed. So
info file and path to the audio PKG, you can keep it anywhere, and we use the --day flag to build locally. If you want to use the latest commit, you can use -8 only. And if you want to check the output, vermost mode here, so you can do this. And what? What was that? Info repo, sorry. Okay, package name, okay, here we go.
So what it is, just getting the package and upping here, it will get the spec file also. Here it has, since spec file is already present, so I have used head only, so this will face the latest commit, and this is the latest commit, and after that it will start creating the environment using mock and chroot, and you can find all the related script within DeLorean script folders. It will take happily 4 to 5 minutes, and after that it will generate the package for you, and it might break also, like the spec file is in still in progress, like, then after that I will package it, like after going home it will be available. So this way we create it, it's very simple. But if you still want to learn packaging, if you have no clue what's happened behind the scenes, you can check this one. It's a nice project. And it's a still has some issues, like you can try that. Yeah, you can learn the stuff. So like why we use build requires and requires, it will give you a better idea. So until this stage, RDO generates the package. Janki is going to explain how to containerize, what to do with that package, so that end user can consume it.
I hope this slides. Thank you.
Thank you, Chandan. That was really nice. So once the packages are available, you can either directly install those packages on the physical host servers or deploy a containerized version of OpenStack. To get a containerized version, you first need containers that are running those services. So the packages are actually installed inside the container. This is defined in a Docker file. For all OpenStack projects, there is a project called Cola, which provides Docker files for all the services. We'll see an example of containerizing Neutron. Neutron again is
the first name.
Neutron. Okay, both are same. Neutron is a collection of different services. One of them is Neutron server. So we'll see how to containerize a Neutron server. Its Docker file is in a Jinja template. It's available at Cola GitHub repo. It says from namespace image prefix neutron base colon tag. So namespace image prefix and tag will be the input that the user provides when we build the images from these Docker files. It says from neutron base, that is fetch the base OS for this container would be Neutron base. We'll see what Neutron base has later on. Apply these labels. This is just for maintenance purposes. The Jinja template has blocks, the header block, which currently does nothing. It has a well-defined macros. These are like common functions that are common to all the OpenStack services, and they do common functionality. If install type is binary, and if your base distro is among these, as mentioned here, CentOS, Oracle, Linux, or RHEL, install the Neutron VPN as a service package, else install the other packages as well. Install type is equal to binary that the user provides. Base distro also the user provides while building the container. Once we have specified the packages that needs to be installed, install those packages. This macro tells the Docker daemon to install the package inside the container. If the install type is source, get the packages, use pip install to install the services as needed. Once it is done, again till here this says install all the pip packages. Once it is done, start the container. This changes the cmode, the ownership for the file. The footer is blank here, and Neutron server footer has no content, and the footer is also has no content. Once the container is started, run it as Neutron user. Let's see now what Neutron base Docker file has. Neutron base says from OpenStack base, this is again another Docker image that is available on Docker Hub. The base header is empty. We are importing the macros. Call username, configure the user as Neutron. If the OS is Debian or Ubuntu, do HAProxy settings, or else for CentOS, install these many packages. for Debian, install these packages. These are the these are the packages that are needed for a particular OS. That's the same thing if the install type is source. For CentOS, RHEL and Oracle Linux, install these packages, otherwise install the other packages. Once this is all, once the packages are decided and installed, do some Neutron related stuff. This makes a directory at this location. Again, copy the content from this directory to etc Neutron. This will copy all the Neutron related config files at etc Neutron slash the respective folders. If there are plugin related config files, it will be at etc Neutron plugins. Otherwise, few of them would be at etc Neutron conf folders. Once this is done, we now see what is in the OpenStack base file. From base image, so this is OpenStack base Docker file, which says from base image, meaning from whatever OS we will be defining in the pola build command, fetch that image first, apply the tag. This is again for the maintaining, apply these labels. This is mostly Kola stuff. It sets the right environment for right operating system. Run current distro release, checks the release of the OS that is running right now. Does yum copy, enable repos. Base repo yum. These are the repo files that are already present in the Kola folder. So this is a grafana.repo file which says where to fetch the grafana packages from. So OpenStack base image says copy the repo file into etc/yum folder, and then when you do yum install grafana, it will fetch the RPM from that particular repo. So what we saw is the base image is always OpenStack base, which defines what repo to enable, which defines the basic packages that needs to be installed. On top of that, depending on the service, the next image layer can vary. For Neutron particularly, we saw Neutron base image is pulled next, which has Neutron related common packages. After that, for Neutron service, there was another Docker file that fetches, that creates a Neutron server image. Once we have these Docker files specified, we build a Docker image with Kola build command. The base image we are giving here CentOS. So all the Docker file wherever there was a base underscore image conditions, the OS comes from this flag here. Type is binary. We saw if you want a binary type or if the installation is from the source. So we are here specifying the type is binary. Namespace is triple O upstream. This is related to Docker Hub. In the Docker Hub, there are different groups. In GitHub, there are organizations. Similarly, in Docker Hub, if you want to separate your images, they are divided into different namespaces. So this will go into triple O namespace. This is the local registry IP and port that I can give. If this is not given, you can also specify an online registry that you want. Tag could be any custom value that you give. Template override. Okay. So suppose in many of the cases, I do not want something that is defined in the Cola Docker file, but I want to override it on runtime. So for that, Cola gives a flag called template override, where you can specify a Jinja 2 template, which will suggest which section of the Docker file to override. If you want to see an example, this is the triple O Cola template override Jinja 2 template that we generally specify. See, in this, there's a specific case of open daylight. If we say base, OpenStack base, OpenStack base says opendaylight.repo is the repo file which needs to be copied to etc yum underscore repos.d. Now the repo file has the content which says the fetch all the packages from the release candidates of OpenDaylight. I am overriding it to fetch all the packages from this particular URL. So all the overriding happens in the triple O Cola template overrides file. These are the other sections that are overwritten. See, this whole particular block overrides the Barbican API footer block. If we see Neutron server, set neutron server packages underscore append is equal to httpd and mode underscore ssn. This line says along with all the packages that were defined in the neutron server docker file, also install these two packages. Hence the word underscore append. If you want to remove anything, the keyword is underscore remove. This particular block overrides the neutron server footer. In the original file, we saw that the footer was empty here. Instead of that, in the footer section, do this run the HTTP related configs in the footer section. So neutron means we have to specify which service Docker image you want to build. So this will build all the images that are dependent on neutron, and dash dash push means push to the registry that we have defined here. If you do not want to push, just don't give this flag and the image would be available locally. It also provides Docker files for non-OpenStack projects. We saw the example of OpenDaylight. This is about customizing Docker file. Now let's say I want to, in this section, in the OpenDaylight repo file, I'm saying, please fetch the RPM from cbs.centos.org. In the override file, I'm saying in the Cola override file, I'm saying please fetch the RPM from nixes.opendaylight.org. Now, I want to specify a particular RPM that I want. So, I'll create a Jinja template, odl_customize.j2. I'll say extend the parent template. This is a tag that Jinja expects. Block is open daylight install. Block is open daylight install. In this block, there is already this much content available. It says set the package to be open daylight, and this package is to be fetched from the repo file mentioned before. But I want a particular package which is available at X URL. So I'll say yum install wget, because the image by default won't have wget installed. Then I'll fetch the RPM via wget. And I'll then yum install that RPM and end block. Once you have defined a Jinja template, you use this to build the Docker image. So Kola build, I want it for CentOS. I can give Ubuntu, I can give Linux, Debian. And I want a binary package for this. The namespace would be triple O upstream to be fed, to be the images to be pushed to this registry. This is the tag that I'm giving. This is important. Template override odl_customize.j2. I'm specifying this particular file with the template override flag to tell Kola build to replace opendaylight_install block from the original Docker file with this particular block that I've specified in the customized Docker file. And then you give OpenDaylight, because that's the service for which I want to build the image, and --  push to push it to the registry specified. So this is how, after a package is built, you can create containerized services for CentOS. One of the major use of RDO is done by CERN. CERN is a nuclear facility in Europe. They use the packages that RDO provides. RDO generally provides packages for CentOS. So they have their own OpenStack cloud operating based on CentOS. And the packages for the OpenStack service packages they get are being provided by RDO. These are some of the statistics about CERN. They are using OpenStack right from SX release. This was ABCDE. This was the 5th release of OpenStack. Currently, we are on 17th release. These are all the OpenStack projects they use in CERN Cloud. The packages for this are again provided by RDO because their base image is CentOS. And these are the numeric statistics they have. 279.1k cores, out of which these many are used and these many are available. They have 3067 users for OpenStack. So the point to be made here is they run a huge cloud with around 7000 VMs running on the cloud, and the OS they run is CentOS and RDO packages. The statistics have been pulled from this PPT, CERN people presented at Dojo, CentOS Dojo. Any questions?
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.